Hi everyone, welcome to Chinese Pod. My name is Guo Neng.
Hi, 大家好，我是甜心。
Today we're talking about people falling asleep in the movie theater.
我们今天要来学瞌睡虫这个词汇。
That's literally a sleepy bug or worm.
So if you want to call someone, oh, you're such a sleepy head, 你可以说啊，你真是个瞌睡虫。
Okay, well, we'll look at that more in a bit, but how about we listen to the dialogue?
好，那我们赶紧来听听今天的对话。
听说你看电影的时候总是瞌睡虫上身，动不动就看到睡着，是吗？
乱讲，我没有总是看到睡着，你看过我睡着吗？没有，没有啊。
我是没有，不过我怎么常常听别人说你在电影院睡觉？
说常常也太夸张，我顶多偶尔会睡吧。
你昨天不是去看了我上次跟你说的那部电影，那你昨天有没有睡？
我记得我没有睡着。
那你记不记得电影里出现了一个你我都很喜欢的台湾演员，大概是演到一半的时候，出现了差不多5分钟，是谁？
有吗？我完全不记得，难道我真的睡了？
We often have people tell us things like,
I gave learning Mandarin a shot, but then I realized I really don't have enough time to commit to it.
Folks who felt this way love Chinese Pod Recap. In as little as 90 seconds a day, you can refresh what you've learned so far while adding a bit of what's new to your daily learning. An innovative language learning tool to fit the busy, fast-paced lifestyle of today's professionals.
Now the lady friend starts off by saying, I've heard that every time you go to the cinema, you fall asleep.
她说听说你看电影的时候总是瞌睡虫上身。好，这里有很多值得讨论的，那我们先分开说一下。第一个，我们先说一下这个瞌睡虫。
Now, 瞌睡 means literally to nap or to feel drowsy, to feel sleepy.
So if you see someone nodding off, you can say, 你看他在打瞌睡。
Okay, so the verb there is 打, to hit, so that is someone dozing off or falling asleep.
Nodding off, 打瞌睡。那瞌睡虫呢是一个名词 ,it's a noun for someone that's sleepy. It literally translates as sleeping bug.
Now when I checked it up in the dictionary, apparently it's from mythology or traditional stories, so perhaps a bug that made people fall asleep.
Worms it its way into you and makes you go to sleep. 也许这就是我们会说瞌睡虫上身的原因。上身呢，大部分都是用来形容一些比较抽象、比较不好的东西。当这些不好的东西影响你的时候，让你变得有一点不一样的时候，你就可以说什么什么上身。
So this means to be inflicted by something? Or...
Almost like possessed.
Okay, so maybe are there any collocations, common pairings with this 上身?
麻烦上身是一个我们常听到的组合。
To be plagued by bad luck or trouble.
或是我们也常听到鬼上身。
To be bothered by ghosts.
To be possessed by a ghost.
Like the Exorcist.
所以有可能我们为什么现在会说瞌睡虫上身就是跟鬼上身那个概念有一点一样。So it's kind of similar to being possessed by a ghost. This magical sleepy worm comes and infects you.
Moving on, they say you're easy to see falling asleep.
对，他们就说他看电影哦，动不动就看到睡着。
Okay, so when you see 动不动就, it means easily or frequently.
对，没错，你可以说哎呀，他动不动就出国。
He's often going abroad.
He's always going abroad. 他动不动啊就换个新女朋友。
He's always changing girlfriends like John Mayer.
没错。所以呢，他动不动看电影就看到睡着。So whenever he's watching a film, he just falls asleep.
Now the man is offended by this. He says, that's BS. People never see me sleeping.
对，他说乱讲。 BS, right? But it's BS if you say it in English, it's kind of a swear word. 乱讲 is just, you're just talking nonsense, right? 我没有总是看到睡着。 你有看到我睡着吗? 没有啊, right? Have you seen me fall asleep? No.
Now she says, I haven't personally. She uses emphasis, 是.
我是没有。不过我怎么常常听别人说你在电影院睡觉?
How come I often hear other people say, you're always sleeping?
那在这里呢,我们听到睡觉,我们刚刚也听到睡着。 那我就想花一点时间讨论睡觉跟睡着有什么不一样。
Okay, so let's look at the first one, probably the most common one. 睡觉, J-I-A-O, fourth tone.
睡觉 is to sleep. It's a verb, to sleep. 宝宝在睡觉。
The baby is sleeping.
诶,Gwilym在干嘛? 啊,Gwilym在睡觉。 So what is Gwilym doing? Gwilym is sleeping.
How about 睡着, Z-H-A-O, second tone?
睡着 is to fall asleep. So just now we heard the verb to sleep, which is 睡觉. Now we learn the verb to fall asleep. 睡着, even in English we distinguish between the two, right? To fall asleep and to sleep is different, right? If the baby was just awake and I walk back in and the baby's asleep, I might be like, oh, 宝宝睡着了.
The baby has fallen asleep.
Just think about the situations in English where you would talk about someone falling asleep. You're trying to highlight that process that they weren't asleep and now they are asleep. 那在这里呢,我就想跟各位同学分享哦,有时候有一些人在晚上总是睡不着。
So sometimes people can't fall asleep.
If you're having trouble sleeping at night, you can say, 我晚上总是睡不着, I cannot fall asleep. 所以你不会说我不会睡觉, I can't sleep. You would say, I'm having trouble falling asleep.
Now he feels she's being way over the top.
他说常常也太夸张。 夸张是什么意思呢, Gwilym?
Over the top.
Or excessive, right? 好夸张哦,太夸张了。
And now he says, at most, I sleep occasionally at the cinema.
对,在这里呢,有一个很棒的词汇大家可以学起来,那就是顶多。顶多。Now
this is a colloquial adverb, and it means at most or at best. So how about a sentence?
我顶多一个星期吃三次披萨吧。At
most, I only eat about 3 pizzas.
So usually this is used to justify something. You're like, come on, I don't eat pizza that much. At most, I do it 3 times a week. 我顶多吃三次的披萨.
Or maybe if your friend needs some money and you've only got 100 on you, you could say, at most, I can give you 80.
我顶多只能给你80块吧. 那偶尔是什么意思呢?
Occasionally.
我顶多偶尔会睡吧. 那接着我们就听到对话里面的女生在问这个男生呢, 他昨天看电影的时候有没有睡着? 那听到他的男生朋友说他没有睡着啊, 今天这个女生就开始给这个男生考试。
Yeah, she gives him a little test to see if he was asleep.
他就说, 那你记不记得电影里面出现了一个你我都很喜欢的台湾演员?
Do you remember when a Taiwanese actor that we both liked appeared?
他还给了个时间啊, 他说大概演到一半的时候, 出现了差不多5分钟,是谁?
So he appeared about halfway through for about 5 minutes. Who was it?
这个女生记性真好,还记得他出现大概5分钟。
Yeah, so she remembers exactly when this guy appeared.
她一定是很喜欢这个演员。没想到这个男生啊,他说,有吗? 我完全不记得。Really?
I don't remember anything.
当你什么事情都记不得呢, 你就可以说我完全不记得。 难道我真的睡了?
Could it be that I was actually sleeping?
这个难道, 各位同学可以学起来。 难道, could it be? 难道他真的喜欢我?
Yes, it's like a rhetorical question, like, don't tell me that he actually likes me.
Could it be that he actually likes me?
Don't tell me you don't know.
难道你不知道? So this could be used sincerely when you're talking about like, oh my god, could it be that I really didn't know something? Or you could use it kind of in a jokey way, like, come on, you didn't know that Chris Hemsworth was already married? 难道你不知道 Chris Hemsworth 已经有老婆了？
Don't tell me you've not heard of Chinese Pod. It's the most famous Chinese learning platform out there.
啊，不说不说，我们先来复习一下一些比较好用的词汇啊。我觉得这个瞌睡虫大家可以记起来，还有瞌睡虫上身。
To be inflicted by sleep bug.
嗯，但是我觉得比较重要的反而是打瞌睡。
To feel drowsy, to fall asleep.
To nod off, right? 打瞌睡。上课的时候不能打瞌睡。When you're in class, you shouldn't fall asleep.
Now how about this? At most, I can only give you 80.
顶多，我顶多只能给你80块。我顶多一个星期吃三次披萨。
And remember the difference between 睡觉 and 睡着。
好，那你们还记得吗？睡觉 is simply to sleep. 睡着 is to fall asleep. 啊，他很快就睡着了。
He falls asleep very quickly.
我总是睡不着。
I can never fall asleep.
宝宝在睡觉。
The baby is sleeping.
好，那说到这儿呢，我们就赶紧再来听一遍今天的对话。
好的。
听说你看电影的时候总是瞌睡虫上身，动不动就看到睡着，是吗？
乱讲，我没有总是看到睡着。你看过我睡着吗？没有，没有啊。
我是没有，不过我怎么常常听别人说你在电影院睡觉？
说常常也太夸张，我顶多偶尔会睡吧。
你昨天不是去看了我上次跟你说的那部电影？那你昨天有没有睡？
我记得我没有睡着。
那你记不记得电影里出现了一个你我都很喜欢的台湾演员？大概是演到一半的时候，出现了差不多5分钟，是谁？
有吗？我完全不记得，难道我真的睡了？
Hey, Tom.
Oh, Tammy, how's it going?
你好，你好。How's your Chinese coming along?
Well, I gave up.
真的吗? Chinese pod no longer?
Well, really, I was so busy, I didn't have the time.
Not the time? You don't have 90 seconds per day?
90 seconds?
Yes, 90 seconds. So you did not try Chinese pod recap?This app, you can insert your learning experience whenever you have even just a little window of time.
90 seconds are enough to go through bite-sized pieces and recap your lessons in Chinese Pod Recap, the app for busy learners that want to use little breaks to refresh what they learned. Chinese Pod Recap synchronizes to your phone so you have what's relevant for you available even if you have no internet connectivity, like on planes or in the deepest tunnels of the New York subway.
Fee, have you ever fallen asleep in the cinema? I've seen you, actually.
我真的非常，我几乎从来没有在电影院里面睡着过，就只有那么一次。
I think you fell asleep in Transformers Age of Extinction.
因为电影实在是太难看了，我根本就不想看，所以我就想说我休息一下。
So, you're just resting your eyes.
对，浪费钱，害我脖子又痛。So it was a waste of money and I had a sore neck afterwards from sleeping upright like that in the cinema. 但是我可以说我上课的时候从来没有睡着过。
你乱讲, you've never fallen asleep in class.
It's 100% true. I've never ever fallen asleep in any class I've attended. 顶多, at most, 打个瞌睡,小小的瞌睡。I've like accidentally just like nodded off quickly, but then I quickly woke up.To attend class.
That's why they made you head girl, because you're straight as a ruler.
没错。好，那希望你喜欢我们今天的课程啊，我们就下次见，再见。
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.chinesepod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number 3069. So just go to www.chinesepod.com/3069 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more. The link again, www.chinesepod.com/3069. ChinesePod.